Hey guys, Steve here from Scotch and Things, and just wanted to make a quick video. I know probably about 2-3 months ago, I posted a video. I had bought a Canik tp9 sfx, and in that video I said how great a gun was, how great the trigger was, how accurate a shooter it was, how much I loved it. Well, this video, I just want to explain why I sold it. It was a super smooth trigger. It was a real accurate gun. I had bought some extra mags for it, so I had 5 of the 20 round mags for it, fully intending to use it as a competition gun. I only had a couple issues where the slide failed to lock back, and that could have been me, it could have been mags, who knows. But otherwise I had zero issues with it. I wish I would have taken a picture of it before. I was getting some barrel wear, and I only had like 500 rounds through the gun, as opposed to my Glocks, I know, that have much higher round counts. There's no finish wearing off the barrel, and that's not a big deal. The gun still performed great. Why I sold it was just simplicity. I fell in love with, and it did. Okay, let me start over. It looked great. It was a fantastic looking gun. All the internet hype is pretty much why I rushed out and got one as soon as I could. I ran out, bought it, loved it, loved the way it shot. But the longer I had it, and every time I'd go to the range, it just, I don't know. It didn't really kind of grow on me. Like, I like to shoot it, but not as much as I enjoyed shooting my Glocks. I just really am used to those guns. You should be able to shoot any gun the same, and I could. The Canik shot great. And you know what? Honestly, I probably was more accurate with it than my 34 I picked up. But I just like shooting the 34 better, so they're really the same gun, and I got such a great deal on a Gen 4 34 that, yeah, I mean, am I going to do some stuff to it? Maybe. I might just leave it how it is and use it like that, because I do enjoy shooting GSSF matches. Like I said, I want to get into some shoot steel and some other stuff that's local to me, but really the Canik, just in my system right now, it didn't have a place. I shoot 9mm Glocks only. I might venture out eventually. I'm thinking about getting a 22 and doing a barrel conversion on it so I can shoot 9 or 40 out of it. I like 9mm. It's cheap to shoot. Like I said, it's what all my Glocks are right now. And I like that I can use the same magazine in any one of those guns. Pretty much. You know, I can use the 17 round mag in my 26 and my 19 and my 34. And it's just easier. So it was kind of hard selling the Canik. I just really enjoyed the way it looked. I don't know. And my brother kind of described it perfect, is the more you shot it, it just felt, I don't know, kind of tippy, if that's accurate at all. How to describe it. I know everybody on the internet loves those guns, and I might pick one up again in the future. Maybe not an SFX, even though I think it's probably the best looking gun out of their line. I'd like to see how just the regular TP9 shoot. I heard they're very much the same, but then again, why get that when I can get a 17 and magazine compatibility? I don't know. If I'm going to venture out and get something different, I might go for a Beretta 92. I don't know. But right now, I'm just going to stick with Glock. You know, my taste might change someday. I'll never get rid of my Glocks. It's just what I like to shoot. The only thing else I have is a 1911 that my brother talked me into, and I do enjoy shooting that, but I don't shoot it as often. I haven't taken that to the range since December, so it's been a good 8 months since I've shot that gun, and I go almost every other week shooting, so if not, once my schedule clears up, I go weekly. During the summer, I try and get out every other week, but during the winter months, I'm shooting once, twice a week, just because that's what my work schedule allows. So I just wanted to kind of post why I'm not going to be making any more videos on the Canik. I think it's a fine gun. It just wasn't for me. And the more I shot it, the more I kind of realized that, you know, that I just enjoyed. I honestly enjoy the 34 better. I know the trigger might not be as good, but it's what I'm used to, and it's what I enjoy. I like the 34 trigger. I like my 19 trigger. I like my 26 trigger. I know that's a big beef with people is Glock trigger. That seems what they always seem to like bash on. I don't know if I'm used to it, but I enjoy it. The trigger was almost too light on that. I know that's just being nitpicky. Like, everybody says how fantastic the trigger was, and it was. It is a great trigger. It's the best trigger that I'd ever shot. So I just want to make a quick video. That's why I sold my Canik TP9 SFX, just for ease of compatibility with the rest of my guns, and I think I kind of rushed into buying it. It was the new hotness, and I really enjoyed the way it looked. You know, I thought for a while, I thought, man, the 34 is just an ugly gun. But once I got it, the more I looked at it, I really kind of liked the look of the 34. It doesn't have the cool, you know, lightning cuts on the side. It's just got that one big chunky cutout on the top of the slide. But, you know, I think the more you're around it, the more you get used to it. And I'm looking forward to getting into some shooting, some competitions with that. I don't know if I'm going to mod it out. Like I said, I might get a 22 and kind of make that the bastard child with all the, you know, I might try my hand at some stippling and stuff like that. But so TP9 SFX is no longer in the I don't know why, armory. It's not really an armor in the arsenal. So if you have any questions, I enjoyed shooting it. I just never really got comfortable with it. So that's all I have to say about that. Talk to you guys later.